Certainly, I don't want to die. But if anyone has to die, let it be me. These were the words of Martin Luther King Jr., a Baptist minister and a civil rights activist. He sacrificed his life for the Afro-Americans in the United States, and his words have touched millions of lives. His famous speech, delivered in 1953 on the steps of Lincoln Memorial, has been an evergreen speech. And today, I am going to orate a small portion of it, and it goes like this. Go back to Mississippi. Go back to Alabama. Go back to Georgia. Go back to South Carolina. Go back to the slums and ghettos of our northern cities, knowing that somehow the situation can and will be changed. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. I say to you today, my friends, so even though we face difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up to live out the true meaning of its creed, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slaves' owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that even the state of Mississippi, state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children would once live in a nation when they would not be judged by the color of the skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, black little boys and black little girls will be able to join hands with white little boys and white little girls as sisters and brothers. This is our hope. This is the faith I'll go back to South with. With this faith, we would be able to improve the chanting discord of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we would be able to work together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that one day we will be free. This will be the day when all God's men would sing with a good note, "My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, land where my fathers died, land of my pilgrim's pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. Let freedom ring from every hill of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. But not even that. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi. And if we let that happen, and we let freedom ring from every village to every hamlet, from every hamlet to every city and every state, we are going to speed up the day when all men, black men, white men, Jews, Gentiles, Protestants, and Catholics would be able to sing with a good note, free at last, free at last. Thank you, God Almighty, free at last."